Okay, let's look at this demo now. I have got a development board ready. We have to open the SDK. I have already unzipped it here, so I will open it directly for everyone to see. It's a BRE peripheral project, and then open the project. Wait a moment. Okay, here's a project structure, and I have added it. Then we will make a battery level variable next. We will have it increment, and you will see this effect in the demo later. And then there's a LED blink feature. Let me look for it. The function of LED blink is realized through a software timer. The interval of this timer is 1 second. And after 1 second, it will go to this callback. To flip the P01 pin, which will blink LED. Then we just need to click compile. After compiling, it will generate an image with MD5 value prefixed by 005C in the directory. Let's take a look. It's under this bin folder that we modify the date to sort. Then you can see 122 image and the date today, May 13th. It's an image that we will burn it later. Be sure to choose the one with the word MP, so it can be recognized by MP tool. Then we are going to burn this image. Let's take a look. We are opening MP tool. In version 1.5.2, open MP tool and select chip C. Of course, there are two other chips, D and E. Everyone choose accordingly to their chip. We choose C and click to confirm and enter. After I go in, I have already loaded the image to be burned here, so I will delete it first. After deleting the default stat, we can see the default stat like this. The default stat is like this. We first need to put in the flash map. Load the flash map. We choose C in MP tool. After selecting this flash map, the tool will show us these five images. So firstly, we explain what the system config file is generated by config set button. Then in this, we choose SWR mode by default. Everyone take a look at this config. The default is that, and after click confirm, the file path here will be. You can also go to the MP tool directory to find this config. Sort by date. Then this config file on May 13 is the config file loaded in the MP tool. Then the OTA header file is generated by PackTool. Then after we click PackTool, we will enter this page. Then there is no content on this page. Well, yes, after the revision, you don't need to use this tool to generate it. After closing it, continue to enter this page. After the revision, our OTA header file is under the directory of MP tool. There's an OTA header directory. Then this OTA header is the image we want to load. Let's load it. Load this OTA header. After loading it, we will look at the secure boot image and room patch image. These two images are what the above video is talking about. We are in the SDK. the deliverable image in SDK edit, loading patch image, loading patch, select the patch. This RF test is when doing RF test and BQB certification. The following image will be used. So for now, we can choose the normal image. Then app image is generated by Kale. We enter the SDK. Then go to the bin folder of the peripheral and sort by time and select the first one. Okay. Then after the five folders are loaded, we will now tick the erase off download button. After ticking the button and when we boom, the program will erase the whole flash on chip first and then burn it. Okay. Well, that's fine. Now we detect it with this tool. Look, we get COM2. It's a green board. Then there's a very important action. Very important. Which is take this location. There's a log port here on P03. There's a log pin here and here. Or let's keep it simple. There's a P03 pin right here. Let me zoom in a little. Take a look. There's a P03. Did you see it? Connect this P03 to GND. I will connect the GND of this row and connect it directly. So after you connect it, we reset it by pressing this red button. In this way, we enter the burning mode. Then at this time, we go to click. Open here, you can see the word OK. And then we go to click download. After clicking download, you will find that it's failed, right? When you see the fail, then we repeat the action just now. Click detect, then click the red button and click again. Then open again and then go to download. At this time, the progress bar starts to go. Now, it shows that the burning is completed. Okay, we click detect. Okay. Now we have to prove whether it's running or not. How to prove it? We are going to grab the log. Now, let's close this tool. The tool to grab the log is here. Let's unzip the debug analyzer. Unzip it. It's already here. It had already been unzipped. Then let's go open the debug analyzer tool. To use it like this, click on this setting. This is opened for the first time, so we will have to load scenes in. Reload our project just now. There's a trace under the bin directory where the image is generated. There is a trace file, an app trace, which is what about the other one with MD5 suffixed just for the image at that time. Do an MD5 check. Then we choose this app trace that will be updated. Click confirm. After selecting confirm, we are still using the COM2 port and then click start. After start, we need to take the P03 first, unplug this wire. After unplugging it, we now need to, look, this log pin. Connect the lock pin with RX, you can see me connecting like this. Everyone take a look. Take a look. Just now, this jump cap was attached to this pin. Then, this jumping cap is to move over and move to the lock pin. Let's take a look and receive it from the lock pin. Okay, so that's it. We are done. This time, press again the reset button. You can see that GapADV started spit out in our log. Then at this time, we can see the broadcast packs in the air. Next, I will show you how this application works.
Hello everyone, let's take a look at this demo. Then, when you get to the development board, it's a berry board without any jumper caps. So now we have to put on these jumper caps. Then we need to connect this interface first. This interface is a burning port. And connect this interface. Then you need to connect the power supply interface. It contains three positions. Here, and here. Yeah, it's all. In this case, the unboxing of the development board is completed. Then I burned a demo program on this board. Now, this board has started to broadcast. In order to make this board look a bit alive, I have added an LED blink function. So, if you connect this interface, the LED will start blinking at a frequency of 1 second. Then, let's use the mobile phone to see what it broadcasts. We scan. Okay, the BLED device with MAC address 5678 is broadcast just like this. Then, we click it and connect. Okay, it's connected. After connecting, let's take a look at the function of this demo. Firstly, open the service of this power supply and then click this button. Okay, we read 90% and follow me. Click again. It's become 91%. Click again and it will increase automatically. When you actually make a product, you will use ADC to collect the power information and replace this value. Okay, then our demo is here. Thank you.